हेलो एवरीवन, हियर इज दलजीत कौर, योर पेंटिंग टीचर। आई होप यू ऑल आर वेरी फाइन। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डन फर्स्ट चैप्टर पार्ट ए, राजस्थानी स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पार्ट बी, द पहाड़ी स्कूल्स। टाइम पीरियड ऑफ दिस स्कूल्स आर 17 टू मिड 19 सेंचुरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट इज geographical situations. The Pahari region comprises of the present state of Himachal Pradesh, the area of Jammu in the Jammu and Kashmir state, and Garhwal in Uttar Pradesh, now in Uttaranchal. The whole of this area was divided into small states ruled by Rajput princes, who were often engaged in warfare. These states were also centers of great artistic activities from the later half of the 17th to nearly the middle of the 19th centuries, as many artists of Rajasthan had settled in the Pahari region due to the fear of the Mughals. These states were also known as sub-schools of Rajput schools of art. Next is origin and development of Pahari art. Pahari miniatures are known for their natural symbolisms, minute details, superb sense of composition, and deep sense of expressing human expressions. It is a creative combination of Gujarat manuscripts, local folk art, Mughal style, and Rajasthani art of first half of 17th century, which had already absorbed the style of Akbar, Jahangir, and Shah Jahan periods. The path of improvement started with indigenous love of color and animated figures in Basoli, fine drawing, delicate coloring, and more charming figures in Guler. To clear simple and mundane treatment in Jammu, and finally to its peak at Kangra and Garhwal, where soft contour and graceful forms of women celebrated the tenderness of love. The beauty of nature in these mountains inspired the artists of these mountains, and they both seem to celebrate the glory of themes of love. Art and artists flourished here freely and independently with the encouraging of Raja Sansar Chand, who would not impose any terms in the following any style of subject matter. As a result, pure Hindu art with both Shaivite and Vaishnavite themes evolved here. The main themes of Pahari regions represented by famous artists are Bhagavat, Geet Govinda, Baramasa, and Ragmala, painted in 1760 to 70 AD. Next are sub-schools of Pahari schools. They are Basoli, Guler, Kangra, Garhwal, Chamba. So let's start first school, Basoli school. It is the earlier center of painting in the Pahari region, where under the patronage of Raja Kirpal Singh, an artist named Devidasa executed miniatures in the form of Ras Manjari illustrations on 1694 AD. The Basoli style of painting is characterized by vigorous and bold lines and strong glowing colors. Primary colors are used here. The Basoli style spread to the various neighboring states and continued till the middle of the 18th century. The most famous example of this style, this school, is Mogad Naika. It is the theme that taken from series of Rasmanjari. The drawing is bold and forceful and the colors are strong and contrasting. The yellow monochrome background used in the miniature enhances the emotional intensity of the scene. There is a change in the facial type, which becomes a little heavier, and also in the tree forms, which assume somewhat naturalistic characters in the Geet Govinda painted by artist Manko. Next school is Guler. The last phase of Basoli style was closely followed by the Jammu group of painting, mainly consisting of portraits of Raja Balwant Singh by Nansuk, an artist who originally belonged to Guler but had settled at Jasrota. These paintings are in a new naturalistic and delicate style, marking a change from the earlier traditions of the Basoli art. The colors are used here now soft and cool. The styles appear to have inspired by the naturalistic style of the Mughal painting of the Muhammad Shah period. The main themes were painted here in this era of school are portraits of Balwant Singh. They have been drawn delicately and have a bright and rich palette. The finest group of miniatures done in Pahari region is represented by the famous series of the Bhagwat and Geet Govinda, Baramasa and Ragmalas, painted in 1760 to 1770 AD. The most famous painting from this school is Krishna is shown killing a demon Vatsasura on the bank of Yamuna. Here is a story is described in this painting. Violent colors are used. The style is naturalistic and marked by delicate drawing and fine modeling of figures and a harmonious color scheme. Next school is Kangra. The Guler style was followed by another style of painting termed as Kangra style, representing the third phase of Pahari painting in the last quarter of 18th century. Kangra possesses the main characteristics of the Guler style, like the delicacy of drawing and quality of naturalism. The name of Kangra style is given to this group of painting for the reason that they are identical in style of the portraits of Raja Sansar Chand of Kangra. His period is considered to be the golden period of Kangra school. In these paintings, the faces of women in profile have nose almost in the line with the forehead, eyes are long and narrow, chin is sharp. The Kangra style continued to flourish at various places, namely Kangra, Guler, Basoli, Chamba, Nurpur and Gadwal. The most famous painting of this style is Celebration of a Festival by Raja Sansar Chand, the ruler of Kangra. In this painting, a festival scene is there. Raja is seated in the company of courtiers under the arched pavilion, which is well furnished and decorated. He is watching a dance performance. In background, a small shrine is there where four devotees are performing worship. The border is red. The painting belongs to National Museum collection and assigned to the end of the 18th century. Nansuk was a famous painter of this school. Next is Gadwal. गढ़वाल स्टाइल हैज़ अ वेरी क्लोज सिमिलैरिटी टू द कांगड़ा स्टाइल विच इटसेल्फ इज एन ऑफ शूट ऑफ गुलेर और इट कैन बी सेड दैट दे बोथ ड्रू इंस्पिरेशंस फ्रॉम अ कॉमन सोर्स गुलेर In 1658, a nephew of Aurangzeb had escaped to this region. Along with him came a few artists. A distinctive style of Garhwal evolved as a result of strong Guler influence after a few martial alliances between the ruler of both the regions. The paintings depict the scenic beauty of local river and hills, the peaceful setting in the backdrop of a beautiful figures in the romantic compositions bring the peace and simplicity that prevailed in India before all external invasions. Another prominent artist of this school is Chetu. नायिका वेदा गीत गोविंदा रामायणा एंड महाभारत वर मेन थीम्स विच वर पेंटेड इन दिस स्कूल. नेक्स्ट इज चंबा. बसोली स्टाइल ऑफ पहाड़ी पेंटिंग्स टुक रूट्स इन चंबा विद आर्टिस्ट माइग्रेटिंग हेयर इन द 18th सेंचुरी आफ्टर द डिक्लाइन ऑफ कांगड़ा स्कूल. राजा उदय सिंह राजा राज सिंह एंड राजा उमेद सिंह patronized the school of painting where portraits and Hindu legends took priority. During the reign of Raja Charut Singh, art reached the masses and folk art influence increased. The paintings of Chamba cover in its miniatures the effect of folk art, murals and the Mughal influences. Chamba school apparently lettered the longest till the 19th century. The paintings were generally painted with the Hindu religious themes that are Radha Krishna, Shiva Parvati, Jashoda and Krishna, Gopis, Krishna Sudama, love scenes and birds and animals. Main painters of this school are Niku from Basoli, Durga and Lehru. Next are paintings of Pahari schools. First one is Krishna with Gopis. Artist Manku, period 1730 AD, school Basoli School of Art, medium, tempera, watercolor on paper, size 20.5 × 37 cm. Subject matter of this painting is, this is a horizontal painting, is an illustration from the Geet Govinda series by painter Jayadeva. It deals with the legends and it play the Radha and Krishna symbolizing soul's devotion to God. Description of this painting. In this painting, 8 gopis are shown adoring Krishna. Blue-skinned Lord Krishna, the charmer, is in the center of the painting, wear a yellow loincloth and fondly embracing 2 of the gopis. One gopi is sitting on her knees and holding Krishna, while the other one is in front of her, is kneeling and touching Krishna's feet. One of the gopi is standing with folded hands on the right with her attendant holding a round fan behind her. 2 gopis are standing on the left talking to each other. There is no competition to win Lord Krishna. The only effort is to please him. Krishna's crown is elaborately designed with feathers at the top. All the similar looking gopis are decked with beautiful ornaments. Green beetle being case is studded in all of them and pearl strings are highlighted. These decorative and dramatic composition has figures clad in rich costumes and bright colors are shown. Stylized faces have large bulging or lotus-shaped eyes, prominent foreheads with hairlines pushed back and nose in the same contour of forehead line, means nose is adjoining with the forehead line. Style bodies are rather short, which shows the impact of folk styles. Hands and feet of the gopis are decorated with red color like the dancers. Here artists want to show they have put on their hands altas. Colors are bright and bold with the lusters enamel like quality. In the foreground we can see a small stretch of Yamuna river in which few small trees of the same height with the different shapes of leaves are drawn on right. On every tree there are different shapes trees. The horizon line is beyond the head of the tallest figure of the Krishna. It seems that the artist wanted to stretch the plain background to give emphasis to his colorful figures, so he pushed the horizon further up. Stylization has been done for ornamental purpose. Beauty of nature complements the devotion of gopis. Next painting is Nand, Yashoda and Krishna with the kinsman going to Vrindavan. Artist Nansukh, time period 1785 to 90 AD. Subject school Kangra school, medium tempera watercolor, sizes 35.5 into 27.5 centimeter. Subject matter is, this painting is based on the story of Bhagavad Puran showing Nand, Yashoda and Krishna with the kinsmen in a scene from their journey while migrating from Gokul to Vrindavan. Nand, a chief of his township, was advised by his people to shift to Vrindavan close to the Govardhan Hill. Kans' court was near Gokul and he was making repeated attempts to harm Krishna, but people wanted to save their future savior Krishna and knew that he was no ordinary human. Description of the painting. This painting depicts a group of people with their cattle cart with a dome-shaped canopy shed drawn. Cattle and other belongings journeying to Vrindavan. Nand is seated on a bullock cart with a dome-shaped canopy drawn by two bulls and driven by a cowherd. On the right side, a cart is carrying baby Krishna. Others accompanying Krishna are possibly Balram, Yashoda and Rohini, his stepmother, foster mother and stepmother respectively. Men and women are carrying their belongings in baskets and tied clothes bundles on their heads and shoulders. A few ladies are carrying jars and spinning wheels can also be seen. Their humble lifestyle is portrayed in their half-clad bodies and simply dressed women. The gagras of the walking women have characteristic horizontal strips. The landscape in the background shows a line of trees having intricate details of leaves and trunks carved along the path, with two rocks in a grove and two birds sitting on them. Color scheme. The lines defining the contour are thin and delicate. The painting has a very supple appeal due to its colors. They are neither too bright nor too gaudy, but still very lively. The sky blue river behind lines of trees, light occur of the ground and cattle are in earthy colors, which has the figures are painted in a bright, whereas the figures are painted in a brighter colors. So this was all.